Hi, here we are to do another daily devotional, and we've been doing the names of Jesus. And yesterday, or the last time we did it, we did the word Lord, and we were looking at the phrase Lord Jesus Christ. And the word Lord carries, of course, with it the absolute authority, and especially when we discover, as we did, that Jesus Christ is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and that He is Lord of all, and every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Now we come to the word Christ, Jesus. We come to the word Jesus. It's a name. And, you know, what's in a name? Well, let's find out what's in the name of Jesus. First thing I want to tell you is that the name of Jesus is not a lucky talisman. It's not something that we use for our own benefit, or that somehow by saying the name of Jesus we're going to cause demons to fall, or we're going to get prayers answered. Now you might say, well, hey, isn't that what the Bible says? I'm going to read some of the verses the Bible says, and then I'm going to look at the context of the use of the name of Jesus. So when we come to this name, let's find out the source of it first of all. The name Jesus was not something that was new. It's not like a new made-up name. Matter of fact, in the Old Testament, the name Jesus was Joshua. Now, you probably heard that name before, of course, because Joshua was under Moses. He was one of the two that were faithful to go into the promised land, and who outlived all the other ones who refused to go. And Joshua was the leader of the armies as they went into the promised land. He was their leader because Moses didn't go. So we come to the name Joshua, and we want to find out, well, what's the meaning of this name? And the beautiful meaning of the name of Jesus is the Lord who saves, Jehovah who saves, God who saves. So that's the name. That's what the name of Jesus means, or the name of Joshua. Or if you want to pronounce it in Hebrew, it would be Yeshua. And that is a common name that is used in Israel by Jews concerning Jesus, Yeshua. The word Jesus is actually a Greek translation of Joshua or Yeshua. And so it is the common name that is used in the English-speaking world, and of course many others as well. However, Yeshua is perfectly acceptable. If I'm in France and I'm reading, and I pick up a book and I'm talking French, I don't say book, I say livre. But livre, book, or it's the same thing, means the same thing. And so just because a name is translated into a particular language does not take away from who that person is. You see, it is the person behind the name. But the name reflects the person. God knows what He's doing. And we discovered that this name was given to this baby who was coming into the world in Matthew 1:18. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. This is familiar territory. We just read it when we were looking at the study of Emmanuel, God with us. This is another title for Jesus that we had looked at. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After His mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled which is spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife. And he did not know her, did not have relations with her, till she brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Now, this is remarkable in these ways. First of all, we know that Emmanuel means God with us. And we saw that this is an incredible title because it's not just that, oh, hey, God's with us, but he's with us in an intimate way. And if you haven't listened to that devotion or watched it yet, please go back and listen to it because it is incredible to reflect on the reality of God being with us. That is just two devotions before this one here. And when you consider this, remember, there's God with us, and then Joseph is told this. Now, listen carefully to this verse here, because it says, you shall call his name Jesus, and the word Jesus means the Lord who saves, Jehovah who saves. It's not less than God. It really means Jehovah who saves, Yahweh who saves. Makes up the word Yeshua. It's a compilation of saying Jehovah who saves. Okay. Now, of course, this name was used in the Old Testament, and there were other people whose name was Jesus, probably, likely many, whose name was Joshua in the New Testament when Jesus was around. So he wasn't the only person named Jesus. But with this announcement, we get clarity as to the usage of this name for this person, because we know that Joshua or Jesus means Jehovah who saves. And then this is what the angel said to Joseph: you will call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Now, does that not give you clarity that Jesus Christ is Jehovah? If you will say to the person, to Joseph, you were there, and you said, you will call his name Jehovah who saves, for he will save his people from their sins. Who's the Savior? Jesus. Who is Jesus? The one who saves his people from their sins. What does Yeshua mean? Joshua, Jesus mean? It means Jehovah who saves. Such clarity, friends, concerning that Jesus Christ is very God, that he is Jehovah, is found all through the Bible, and here we find it in this very passage. So the name was given to this child, and this child is Jesus Christ. It is in his name that salvation comes. But we have a passage in Acts 4:12 that says this, and I'm going to read Acts 4, chapter 4, from 9 to 12. And all of this is vitally important to you, my friend, because if you are looking for answers, if you're looking for hope, if you're looking for salvation, if you're looking for life, you are going to find it in Jesus Christ, because he is Jehovah, because he is God himself. Came to earth. He is God. Friends, God came to be with you. Now, get with the program and be with God. So here's what it says in Acts 4:9. And this was just after Peter and John had gone up to the temple to pray, and a man who was crippled from birth, he made him well. And it says this, Acts 4:9, if we to this day are judged for a good deed done to a helpless man, by what means has he been made well? Let it be known to you all, and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now you see, he tied together Jesus, Christ being the Messiah, and we'll talk about that probably briefly tomorrow. We've already looked at Messiah from the Old Testament viewpoint, but perhaps we will look again at this translation of Messiah is Christ in the New. And by the name of Jesus, the Messiah, the promised one, the Christ, of Nazareth. He wants to be specific here. There may be other people named Jesus, but I want you to know exactly who we're talking about here. It is this one, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It says, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man stands before you whole. By him? By who? Jesus Christ of Nazareth. This is it. This is the stone which was rejected by you builders, which has become the chief cornerstone. Now there is salvation, nor is there salvation in any other. There's no other. There's no other way to be saved. For there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Now, if you believe the Bible at all, you have to come to this conclusion. There's only one name that people can be saved by. Saved by a name. How can I be saved by a name? There's no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. You see, when the Bible speaks of a name, it speaks of the person. The name is representative of the person. The name in itself, as I said, is not the be-all and the end-all. It's the person behind the name. There is no other name. There is no other person. There's no other one. This is the only one that can save. So, of course, there is power in the name of Jesus. And we'll see that as we read here. But you cannot take the name without the person. In the book of Acts, we had seven sons of Sceva who thought that they could use the name of Jesus. And they saw the success that Paul had in dealing with people who were demon-possessed. And these seven sons of Sceva, they were professional at exorcising demons out of people, or so they thought. So they said, well, Paul's using the name of Jesus, let's use it too. So they came to this person who was violently possessed, and they tried to cast out in the name of Jesus, whom Paul uses, they said. And the demon said, Jesus we know, and Paul we know, but who are you? And they ripped the clothes off of them, violently attacked the seven of them. They ran, fled from the house where they were. Why? Because they tried to use the name, but they didn't know the person. So people can say things in the name of Jesus, and they may say it loudly, and say, in the name of Jesus. It doesn't mean a thing unless they are in communion with the person. Do you follow what I'm saying? Sometimes people, it's almost like, okay, here's my lucky pen. I'm going to, by this pen, I'm going to go forward. And that may sound ridiculous, but how many people are trusting in lucky things? They've got their little idols, and they think that these are going to help them get them through stuff. Lucky pennies, whatever it might be. And so, Jesus, the name of Jesus is not like that. It's not some lucky name. The power that's in the name of Jesus is in the person of Jesus. You cannot separate them. And if you try to do that, if you try to attach the name of Jesus to whatever it is you want, it won't go anywhere. There is no power there. There is power in the name of Jesus Christ. It is because of the person of Jesus Christ. If you don't know the person, then you don't know the name. You might be able to say the name, but what does it mean? Nothing. Because just previously, Peter said to this crippled man when he was at the gate, the temple, he said, silver and gold I do not have, but what I do have I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. So the name of Jesus meant something, but it meant something to those who knew his name and walked with him. The name of Jesus was what they went forth speaking and preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we can see verses throughout. Well, we find, for example, in Acts chapter 5:40, the Sanhedrin, that is the group of people, the religious rulers in Israel, they had taken the apostles and beaten them. But then they commanded them not to speak in the name of Jesus. They didn't want them to speak in that name. They didn't want them to preach in the name of Jesus Christ. And the world still doesn't want the name of Jesus. And they'll put up with an awful lot of different religions and different ideas and everything, but exclusively saying that only Jesus Christ is the way and that you need Jesus Christ as your Savior offends people deeply. But I cannot find another name. I cannot find another person in the annals of history that can stand up and be the Savior of the world. There is only one, and it is God who saves. It is Jehovah who saves. Jesus Christ, Yahshua. It's Him. There is no other name. And so that's why in Philippians 2:10, it says this, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. You know, it doesn't even use the words here, the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It says just at the name of Jesus, God who saves, every knee will bow, and every tongue, if those in heaven, those on the earth, and those under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So we have this wonderful truth that in the name of Jesus, we have victory. In the name of Jesus, we move forward. In the name of Jesus, we see God working in His mighty power. Jesus said, whoever receives one little child like this in my name receives me. Jesus said, Matthew 18:20, where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there in the midst of them. For many, and then there's the false teachers who will come and say, many will come in my name saying I am the Christ and will deceive many. Don't go after them. How do we know the difference? The difference is that I'm not just coming with the name, I'm coming with the person. I'm coming in His authority. I'm coming with the Spirit of the living God. Because if I'm not born again of the Spirit of God, then I don't have the name of Jesus. I might say the name, but I don't have it. And that is very possible. Did you know that in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, it speaks of people coming in the name, having another Jesus. It says they came with another gospel, another spirit, and another Jesus. Not the Jesus of the Bible. So the word, the name Jesus can be used, but it can be abused. Jesus said, whoever gives a cup of water to drink in my name, because you belong to Christ, I tell you, he by no means lose his reward. What's interesting in this verse is it says this. This is in Matthew 9:41. Whoever gives you a cup of water to drink in my name, because you belong to Christ, surely, I say to you, he by no means lose his reward. There's a belonging to Christ associated with the name of Christ. You have to belong to him. So, Jesus encouraged us to pray in his name. In that name, ask me nothing. John 6:23, but assuredly I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give to you. John 16:24, until now you've asked nothing in my name. Ask and you will receive that your joy may be full. So, this is what we've discovered about the name of Jesus. It is integrally tied to the person of Jesus. If you don't know the person, don't bother using the name. But come to Him. Cry out in the name of Jesus. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved. And as you walk with Jesus, this precious name, this wonderful name, you discover more and more of the person of who He is. The name of Jesus. Oh, there's no other name, friends. Precious, wonderful, incredible. In the name of Jesus, Christians live, walk, and go forward. This is what the apostles did. They preached in His name. They did many wonderful works in His name. Now, there are those who would do fakery. There's no question about that. But that does not change the genuine. There is a genuine Savior. And it is God, Jehovah, who saves. Jehovah is salvation. He, Jesus, will save His people from their sins. Are you saved? Have you been saved by Jesus Christ? If not, call on His name. For whoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Will you call on his name today? Will you call out to Jesus Christ? Will you call out to him and believe in him, trust him as your Savior, ask him to save you? And he will. He will, friends. He died on the cross for your sins. He is God who saves. So trust him today. And if you are a believer, revel in his name, worship him, proclaim his name, and live in his character, with him. Don't separate his name from his person in any way, shape, or form, because his name represents who he is. He is God who saves. Amen. Here's a little chorus called In the Name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, demons have to flee. Tell me who can stand against us when we call on that great name. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, we have the victory. In the name Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, demons have to flee. Tell me who can stand against us when we call on that great name. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, we have the victory. Amen. In the name of Jesus, my friend. Go in his name. Preach in his name. Pray in his name. Believe in his name. Walk in his name. There's no other name under heaven. But remember, every time we mention his name, it's his person that we're speaking of. It's his presence. It's him. It is Jesus. Never detach his name from his person. Amen.